Welcome to Daily Steps from One Extraordinary Marriage, where we outline simple steps that you can take to have the ultimate marriage adventure. I'm Tony DeLorenzo, your co-host, along with my beautiful wife, Elisa. In today's show, we answer the question, what do we do if her vagina is super tight and I can't even get in?
First off, let me just start by saying that Tony and I are not doctors.
We are not. We are not MDs.
And so please always go back to your medical professional for any diagnoses or things like that.
Correct.
But that being said, this does sound like it could be a condition that's called vaginismus. Mm-hmm. And what that is, it's when the vaginal muscles squeeze or spasm upon something entering it. Women who have this condition actually struggle even with tampons or with gynecological exams because it's an involuntary spasm of those muscles.
Okay, so wait, let's break this down. So there are muscles inside of the vagina.
Right. Your pelvic muscles. There's right. All kinds of muscles down there.
All right. And so with the insertion of a penis or even like you said, a tampon or
gynecological exam,
that will cause that spasm.
Actually in advance of it. Right. So it can, and it's, you know, as you read in the medical literature and things like that, it's a burning sensation. It's, you know, it's basically like a tightening.
Okay.
Of those muscles to the point where, you know, even in doing some research for the show, just reading about women who, you know, for years haven't been able to consummate their marriage because the husband is not able to get in.
Wow.
Right. And, you know, it's a condition. First of all, guys, let me just tell you that this is not a rejection of you. This is her body responding involuntarily. So I want to put it out there that she's not like, I'm not letting you in and, you know, whatever. That's not happening. And there can be a lot of different causes for this. There can be physiological causes. There can be emotional causes. It can be a response to, past trauma and things like that. And that's why, you know, there's no one simple answer to what to do about this.
Now, there are other things that maybe we're specifically talking about vaginismus.
Correct. Right. And so there could be other things going on, which is, again, why we want to go back to, go see your medical professional.
Correct.
But we want to shed some light on this because, one, it's hard for a woman to go into her doctor and say, I've got pain down there or it's not working. Right? People feel embarrassed and awkward, right? And so we want to give you some language around it. We want to give you this short conversation so that we can start bringing these types of things out into the light so that you're not living in this place where you feel like it's only me. Because there are lots and lots of women, I don't know the exact number, who suffer from this. It's even hard to get actual numbers because it's so underreported because women feel awkward talking about it.
Mm-hmm. And it must be tough too. I mean, I would think that as a woman who is in a marriage, you want to have sex.
Correct.
And yet you're trying to figure out what's going on for a husband, not really understanding why she is rejecting you, right? Because she can't even put into words and you're probably sitting there going, is this true or not? And we're here to tell you that it is. It's an actual condition.
Correct. And so the other thing that we want to share with you is that there are treatments out there, right? If this is you, and I've had coaching clients who have dealt with vaginismus and they've gone to different treatment centers, and some of the treatments involve therapy, right? Talk therapy, sexual therapy. There are also things out there called dilators, which actually start, this is so fascinating to me, and I've talked to some of my coaching clients about it, they actually start out the size that is smaller than a tampon, just to be able to basically get something in.
Okay.
And then over time, again, this is all under the supervision of a medical professional, they increase in size, right? So basically it's prescribed stretching of the vaginal muscles to create an environment where a woman is used to it and is comfortable with it.
Okay.
But that's a process, right? It's not like one day you've got this muscle spasming and the next day you're like, poof, I'm all better. Let's just jump into this. There's a process.
It's almost, when you say that and I think about it, I almost think of physical therapy.
They actually refer to it, there is physical therapy involved in this too.
Okay. And that's what I was just thinking about. You know, somebody gets in a traumatic car accident or something and they have surgery, they just don't get up and get moving again. They're going in and there is physical therapy to help them maybe move that arm, that leg. Well, this is the same thing. This is a muscle that is tightened and needs to be loosened.
Such a great description of that process and such a great way to compare it to other, muscle trauma, other muscle spasms out there. And the important thing to know is that you don't have to continue living this way. Mm-hmm. If there is something going on in your marriage sexually, like if there's a situation where it's not working, don't continue to live that way. Go out and get the help, because it is critical for your marriage that the two of you get the help that you need no matter what you are facing.
This question came in from someone here in the Daily Steps family, and we want to let you know that we can answer your question. Send an email to dailysteps@oneextraordinarymarriage.com and put subject line Daily Steps question. If this is something that you struggle with in your marriage, check out Coaching with Elisa. Go to oneextraordinarymarriage.com/coaching.